Hey friends, welcome to Robin's Brews for the final episode of our Gratefulness Challenge for the month of April. And I'm laughing already because I was taking selfies instead of starting a video. You would think after 30 days I would have figured this out, but evidently I'm a dum-dum. And that's the planes overhead that you can hear. And those are the cars in the background. It's noisy today. I don't know what's going on. Everybody's making noise because it's the last day and we're so excited. Yay, last day! All right, I've missed the last 2 days, but it's not entirely my fault. It was my birthday and my family was doing things for me, so that was really nice. And so I missed a couple days. So I'm going all the way back to April 28th. That was my birthday. And this is my birthday hat that Hannah Larson said I should get for myself. So I did. She had to talk to me for so long before I decided to do it. I mean, it was seriously probably like a 2-hour conversation of her like really working hard to convince me to buy me something for myself. That's totally a lie. She said like one thing and sent me a link and I was like, okay. Anyway, it's my first Patagonia thing and I'm a little bit excited about it. So there you go, Hannah. You said you wanted to see it. Ta-da! Did it! Okay. First thing. Sorry, I'm moving the camera around a lot because, I don't know, I'm excited too, I guess. First thing for April 28th, I'm thankful for tacos. I was looking over my list for the month and could not believe that I made it to the 28th day before I said something about tacos. I love tacos. In fact, even one of my favorite children's books is called Dragons Love Tacos. That's how much I love tacos. I made deconstructed tacos for myself tonight. I would eat tacos every day. I just love tacos. And my family was so sweet, and so was Taco Bell, thank you very much. They gave out free tacos on my birthday, and so we went to Taco Bell for lunch on my birthday. I love tacos. Tacos are the best. Next thing for April 28th, I'm thankful for Bible study. Also, not sure how I made it this far into the month without really talking about Bible study. I mean, I talked about scripture, and but I didn't ever really say I'm thankful for Bible study. I love Bible study. I think I first fell in love with Bible study in high school when I was at camp, and we were doing the, well, in Alaska, they called it TLC, TCL. Something like that. Anyways, it was like the leadership training, you know, like your junior staff program. And we, our leader taught us how to do Bible study. And I had never really learned anything about it. I mean, we'd read the Bible in church and stuff, but never really Bible study. I love Bible study. I'm super thankful for that I get to do it. So Bible study. Next, I'm thankful for the body of Christ. You know, on my birthday, I got to do Bible study with a bunch of women, and then they sang me happy birthday, and it brought tears to my eyes. I was crying. So grateful for the body of Christ and how we can show love for each other and support each other and go through this life together. It's so great to have other believers, people with like-minded thoughts and who are trying to live the same way. I'm super thankful for the body of Christ. April 29, that would be yesterday, I wrote down, I'm thankful for telephones. I talked on the phone yesterday, seriously, for almost 3 hours, I think, between my sister and my mom and friends. I'm super thankful for the telephone, especially in a time of quarantine. How great is it that I can call somebody in Alaska and talk to them about my day and how things are going. Thank you, Alexander Graham Bell, for the telephone. Also, thank you, iPhone, because I love my iPhone. So that would be Steve Jobs. Thanks, Apple. Next thing for yesterday, I'm thankful for commentaries. This goes along with Bible study. I love me a good commentary. I do not know everything about the Bible. Don't drop your phone. And I love to learn more. And so I love commentaries because they are men written by men and women who have studied and dedicated their lives to really working things out. And I love that. I love that they can help me learn about the Bible and the God I love. So commentaries are awesome. Last thing for yesterday. How did I make it to the 29th of April without saying how much I love sunsets? For crying out loud. I was hoping there would be a good one tonight because it is sunset time, but it's not a good one. And you can't really see. So, bummer. But I love a beautiful sunset. I love all the different colors that God paints the sky. And everyone is different and unique. And also, I'm much more of a night person than a morning person. So if sunrise is your thing, this is like kind of the opposite. But sunrises and sunsets are both beautiful. And I love a beautiful sunset. All right, here it is. Drum roll. Today, April 30th. The three things I am thankful for. I'm thankful for the beach. I love the beach. I also don't know how I made it this far without ever saying how much I love the beach. The beach is just the greatest. I could live at the beach. In fact, Mark and I kind of hope to have a house at the beach someday because the beach is fantastic. I love the sound of the waves. I love the feel of the sand. I did not grow up at the beach. But I'm a beach baby at heart, and I just love the beach. Everything about the beach, just love it. Love collecting shells, love walking on the beach, swimming at the beach. I love it all. Just the animals at the beach. Love the beach. Second to last thing for the month of April. I love free stuff. I hope that's okay to say. I love free stuff. I'm kind of a scrounger, which I totally blame on my dad. Who may or may not have dug things out of the dumpster my entire life. Some people throw some really good stuff away, and there's nothing wrong with it. We're not eating out of the trash. Well, we're not usually eating out of the trash, actually. But mostly it's stuff, like lawn furniture. I've salvaged lawn furniture out of the garbage. I've salvaged a lot of things out of the trash. People throw good stuff away. I love free stuff. Free stuff is my favorite category on Craigslist because people throw great stuff away. I love free stuff. And speaking of free stuff, my favorite final thing, my gift that I'm counting every moment of every day for all eternity is my salvation. Totally free gift of God for anyone who wants it. Jesus paid the price so that I could be his forever, so that I don't have to be separated from God, so I can spend eternity with him in heaven. It is the bestest of the best of the best of all the gifts. I hope you have it. I hope you know him. If you don't, please, please private message me or call me on the phone. Write me on Facebook or drop me a comment on YouTube. I would love to talk to you about Jesus. He is the best ever. And the salvation that he gives is free. Awesome. And anyone can have it. I hope you stuck with us all the way to the end of this gratefulness challenge. We're going to do something new for the month of May. So stay tuned for tomorrow. I love that I have sisters out there all around who are sharing this time, who are also counting their gifts. Keep counting. Don't stop. Gratefulness will change your heart. It will change your life. Your outlook determines your outcome. Let's keep thanking God, who is the good Father, the giver of all gifts. We'll see you next time. Bye.
Why don't you join the group? It's better than being a party poop. Obligato, pizzicato.